Paranormal activity on the ghost walk. We've had quite a lot on camera, some quite good photographs there. Lincoln and York are very similar with their history, so we go back hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of years. But a lot of them are recording in times, so that's why you probably get the Roman and the medieval ghosts. I love Brown's Pie Shop. They've had quite a few stories there over the years. The main one is when the chef used to come in at 3 a.m. He used to like to prepare his food and veg on his own. But he became aware over 6 to 8 weeks that naughty, childish things had started happening. He eventually said this was a little boy of about 10. Who he christened Humphrey. I don't know for what reason. He didn't tell anyone about Humphrey, but spoke to him every morning when he came in, locked the door. Morning, Humphrey, you all right today? Chat, 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 doesn't matter, no one's around. But then we had our Christmas market. We have about 160,000 visitors pass the shop. He, the chef, has to come in every day during the day, not at night. He's not going to talk to a ghost in front of everyone else. So Humphrey was ignored. Busy working away in the kitchen, carving some meat, when he heard the door slam. He assumed he hadn't turned the key far enough. But when he came down, the door was locked. There was no key in the keyhole. So he's trying to work out that mystery as he goes back into the kitchen. The knife he'd left on the table is now at the other side of the kitchen, sticking out of the floorboards and quivering.